The Space Wolves are a noble and honourable chapter of Astartes, as fierce as they are courageous. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint one of the legendary Grey Hunters up to battle-ready standard using the contrast method. Now, we've already undercoated our model here with Grey Seer Spray, and the first thing we're going to do, as you might not be surprised to hear, is to give a liberal coat of Space Wolves Grey contrast paint all over the armour. So, grab yourself your medium shade brush here. Just going to take a bit of our paint out of the pot. Now, we're not going to thin this down a little bit, but we do want to make sure we're not overloading the brush. There we go, that's about right there. Now, onto the miniature. Here we go, we're just going to apply it quite liberally all over the armour of our Space Wolf. Now you want a quite heavy coat here, make sure you're covering everything, and don't worry if you go onto areas of the model that are not part of the armour, as I've done here. We're going to go back later on and tidy it up with Grey Seer. So we've applied the Space Wolf Grey all over the armour. You can see it's given this really cool effect, but you can also see we've hit quite a few areas of the model that aren't the grey armour. So the next thing we're going to do is tidy up those areas using the Grey Seer paint out of a pot. Grab yourself your medium layer brush here. Let's take a little bit of Grey Seer out of the pot like so. Thin it down just a little bit, just to make life a little bit easier for you, help the paint flow onto the model a bit better. And then onto the miniature, we're just going to tidy up all the areas that aren't the grey armour. So the shoulder pads, the head, various bits of golden detail, bone, that sort of thing. And once you've done that, we'll be ready to move on to the next contrast stage. So there we go, you can see we've reapplied Grey Seer to areas that are not the power armour, and we're ready to put down some more contrast paints. We'll start off next with Basilicanum Grey, and that's going to go onto the metal areas of our Space Wolf and also the areas of stone. Then we'll use Iandan Yellow on his left shoulder pad, Blood Angel's Red on his right shoulder pad, and then we'll hit a few areas with Black Templar, but we'll come to that in a second. So first of all, grab your medium layer brush here, we're going to use our Basilicanum Grey like so. Now again, we're not thinning this down, we're just going to make sure we're not overloading the brush too much. And on our Grey Hunter, we're just going to apply the Basilicanum Grey to the metal areas, basically the entire bolt gun, minus the little skull that's on the side there. And also any areas of stone on our model, so you can see he's got a little stone pendant on his neck there. Also got the grenade around his waist, any other areas of metal and stone. Now that the stone and metal are painted, it's time to apply Iandan Yellow to the left shoulder pad. Be as neat as you possibly can here, try not to go onto that Space Wolf armour. Next up, we're applying Blood Angel's Red to the wax of the Purity Seal and also to his right-hand shoulder pad. Again, be as neat as you possibly can here. Don't worry, if you do make a mistake, you can always go back and neaten it up with a Grey Seer paint. With the red applied, it's time to move on to the Black Templar contrast paint. We're going to be applying this to the joints in the power armour, such as here, the casing on our gun, such as here, but we're also going to be putting the pack markings of the Grey Hunter pack on the shoulder pad too. To do this, we're going to take the centre point at the top of the shoulder pad like here, draw a line down to the bottom of the shoulder pad like so, and on the other side over here like so, forming a triangle on the shoulder pad like this. I'm going to fill that in with the Black Templar contrast paint. There we go. Then we're going to take a little bit more of the contrast paint, draw a line on this side up to the top like so, and then fill that in. And we'll do the same on the other side as well. Be as neat as you can here, and don't worry if you make a mistake, you can always go back with the Blood Angel's Red and neaten it up. So you can see the Black Templar has been applied to the areas we wanted it to be, and we've neatened up that pat marking on the shoulder pad there by reapplying some thin lines of Grey Seer and putting Blood Angel's Red back over the top of it. So now it's time to move on to the rest of our contrast paints. We're going to start off by applying Nazdreg Yellow to the golden areas of our Space Wolf, and there's quite a few of those. Then we'll apply Gilliman Flesh to the Space Wolf's face, Saigor Brown to the hair and leather of our model, and finally we'll be using Skeleton Horde for the parchment, bone and teeth. So once again, grab yourself your medium layer brush here. I'm just going to take a bit of our Nazdreg Yellow out of the pot like so. Now this is super important to be as neat as you possibly can, so we're going to make sure there's not too much paint on the brush like that. And then on our miniature, we're just going to apply Nazdreg Yellow very carefully to all the gold trim. Remember, be as neat as you can, but don't worry if you make a mistake here, you can always go back and neaten it up later on. With the gold details painted, it's time to apply Gilliman Flesh to our Space Wolf's face. Next up, we're applying Saigor Brown with a medium layer brush to the model's hair and various parts of the leather, such as the pouches and the straps. This time we've slightly thinned it down with just a touch of contrast medium. Next up, we're using Skeleton Horde to pick out the areas of parchment, but also all the areas of bone all over the Space Wolf, of which there's quite a few, so make sure you get them all. And there we go, with the final contrast paint applied, our Space Wolf Grey Hunter is almost ready for the battlefield. In fact, there's only one thing left to do, and that's to apply a textured base to our model. Now, space walls are from Fenris, and that's a famous ice world, so we're going to apply a snow base to our model. The way to do that is like this. First of all, we're going to take a normal texture paint first. We're using Stirling Battlemar, but you can use whichever one you like, and apply it onto our base. After that's dry, we'll then apply Valhalla Blizzard snow paint over the top of that. So, as always, when using a texture paint, we're going to use our medium texture tool like so. Take a little bit of paint out of the pot like this. Nice big dollop. And then onto our miniature, we're just going to apply it carefully onto the base. Find a large area like this and just apply it like so and start moving it around with the tool. Now be very careful when you're putting this stuff on the base. In fact, when you get near the model's feet, you're just going to flip the tool around, use the thin end like so. This wants to be fully dry before we move on to the next stage, so allow it to dry for about 30 minutes or so. With our Stirling Battlemire dry, it's time to apply Valhalla Blizzard. We're going to use large clumps like this, again using our medium texture tool. Let's apply it on top of the base like so, spreading it on like this. Now you can apply it either all over if you want to, or as I'm going to do, leave patches, leaving some of the texture paint dry underneath. Now once we've applied this on our base, we're also going to paint the rim of the base with Steel Legion Drab. Leave about 30 minutes for our Valhalla Blizzard to dry fully, and when it's done, we're going to paint the rim of the base with Steel Legion Drab. And there we go, with the snow base applied, our miniature is battle ready. And that's how you paint Space Wolf miniatures up to battle ready standard using the contrast method. Now something very important to remember here is that the Space Wolf miniatures tend to be covered in detail and can be quite fiddly to paint. So when you're using contrast paints, be as neat as you possibly can. Don't worry if you make a mistake though, you can always go back with your grey sear paint from a pot and reapply the contrast over the top of it. Hope you found that video useful. Happy painting.